Hello friends, welcome to our YouTube channel Class Guide. Today we are going to show you some high class attacks performed on Town Hall 12 Airbase with Electro Dragloons, that is a combination of Electro Dragons and Balloons. In the second half of the video, we will be giving you a full explanation on how to make use of Electro Dragons and Wall Wrecker both offensively and defensively. If you are new to this channel, don't forget to watch our other Clan War videos. So now let's get started with our main video. Welcome again. So today we are showing you how much the brand new Town Hall 12 troops are really worthwhile carrying them in the Clan Wars, considering the stress of playing Clan Wars where new experiments are a bit too risky and could cost you dearly in Clan Wars. So the key is to make sure we get good high percentage 2 stars, 3 stars if luck favors. For the luck to favor, you have got to be brave strategically. Anyway. Evidently, there is a contrasting difference between a normal Dragloon attack and the advanced Electro Dragloon attack. As we know, the Dragon's splash damage is quite limited and in normal circumstances goes undetected. However, if you watch them closely, the Dragons do the splash damage if the targeted building has smaller buildings nearby like the Builder's Huts, etc. Apart from that, there is nothing significant and there is not much to talk about the Dragon's splash damaging capabilities. But the splash damage occurred by the Electro Dragons has long range with large DPS. For the Electro Dragons to be effective, they need to be accompanied by some other flying units. So we have carried both the Electro Dragons and the Loons as our main components for the war, as you can see. While the Electro Dragons act as meatball shields and soak up the damage, Loons can take down the defenses quickly. Thus they both act in unison. Now that would serve our purpose, wouldn't it? Now we have got the heroes to have a bit of party on the base, right? But hey, before that, there is one more component to talk about, and that is Wall Wrecker. What Wall Wrecker does is that it starts breaking walls in a line straight to the Town Hall. The Wall Wrecker treats the Town Hall as its primary target, so the Wall Wrecker makes its way to the enemy's Town Hall. So we are going to have to deploy our hero just behind the Wall Wrecker so that the heroes advance straight to the core where the Town Hall is situated. Moreover, once the Wall Wrecker reaches to its location, it will get the company of the heroes. And as for the spells, we need to switch between the available spells as per the nature of the base. Here we have carried the Rage and Freeze spells for our attacks. Now to give you some insight about an Electro Dragon, like how it approaches a target and in what precedence. Actually, it has no specific target, that is nothing preferred. It simply attacks the nearest building, that is the closest building inside, but it will leave its active target in case it gets aware of the enemy's clan castle troops, the heroes or the skeletons. Here in this case you can see, as soon as they get aware of the clan castle troops, they move out of their current attack and now they get engaged with the clan castle troops. Apart from this, it has a special form of attack that is known as chain lightning, much like the Mega Tesla from the Builder base. The chain lightning allows an Electro Dragon to hit up to 5 targets at once, as you can see it here. It hits 5 targets at once, but with decreasing damage for each target chain. When destroyed, the Electro Dragon causes the nearby ground to be struck with lightning bolts in a similar fashion to the lightning spell. Now here in this video you can see the dragon is at most on the verge of dying, and when it dies you will see the lightning bolts that will come out once it dies. Here as you can see here, once it gets destroyed there is a lightning bolt on the ground. So now how we can use them offensively? Apparently the Electro Dragons act as flying ballers. The Electro Dragons split bolts of lightning that bounce from target to target, so we can use them to take out multiple buildings at once. Now how we can use it defensively? The chain attack is only possible if the target buildings are at most one tile apart, or one or less tile apart. The chain lightning form of attack comes into play. In order to avoid such punishment from the Electro Dragons, better we consider placing our buildings two tile apart if possible, from dealing them more damage. This is how we can minimize damage from getting incurred from the chain lightning form of attack caused by the Electro Dragon. Some may say it's quite heavier punishment at this moment, especially when the latest entrants haven't upgraded their defenses fully as yet. I would think that the number of targeted units, that is 5 by the Electro Dragons from Chain Lightning, is way too high, as there are few innocent defenses that get in the way of the Electro Dragon. So I hope Supercell at some point will bring this number down as part of the balancing update. Now talking about the Wall Raker. It considers the Town Hall as its primary target and fights its way through the enemy buildings and walls to reach its location. As soon as it reaches the Town Hall, it breaks apart to reveal the Clan Castle troops inside. Wall Raker, to me, I think it is good for Town Hall 12, maybe a freebie for Town Hall 11 as well, but at the same time it weakens the Town Hall 10 bases. As earlier, it used to take some skills to deal with the once famous ring type base and few others, particularly at Town Hall 10s. Now it would be a lot easier to be starting a Town Hall 10 with. Imagine that some of the guys at Town Hall 11s might have felt their lives difficult attacking another Town Hall 11s. So that's how a Wall Raker and other updates chip in. But I guess the updates were the need of the hour. That's it, friends, in this segment of this video. Hope you like this. Thank you.